So we can strain it. Just pour it over the strainer. Hello, welcome to Home Cooking with Song Jit. In this video, I'm going to share with you how to prepare the tamarind water or tamarind juice for easy usage for cooking. When we prepare the tamarind water like this, it's very easy. Just take out and use. No need to, each time we want to use, just need to soak, squeeze, strain and use it. So do it once and you can use it for a long time. All right. So normally in Malaysia, when we buy Asam Jawa or tamarind pulp, it comes in the packet like this. So this is a packet of 500 gram. Right. Normally the tamarind pulp, they will pack it like this in such a way, and normally the tamarind pulp, it comes like this. It still have the seed and also the flesh. What we're going to do is I'm going to quickly give it a rinse and then we can cook it. All right, after I have rinsed it, this is how it looks like, and it's a bit wet, so I'm going to put it in the pot that I'm going to cook it. Straight away put it in, and then we're going to use just a fork and spoon to separate them. All right, and I'm going to put in the water. This is about 500 ml of water. Once we put in the water, and we're going to cook it. Switch on the heat. You can continue to break it like that, or you can just leave it. Alright, so I'm going to bring it to boil. See, the Asam Jawa or the tamarind is boiling. We will continue to boil, right, until all the flesh drop off from the seed. Maybe it will take around 10 to 15 minutes. If it's too thick, you can add a little bit more water. Another 200 ml of water. Because we're going to continue to boil for some time, right? Or else it's going to be super, very concentrated. Cannot strain it. Okay, I'm going to continue to boil for another 15 minutes. Alright, it is boiling. Look at that. We want to continue to boil until the tamarind seed is dropped off from the tamarind pulp, and then see the consistency. We need to make it slightly watery because once it cools down, it might be slightly thicker. So it's okay now. Okay, so we can strain it. Just pour it over the strainer. You can strain it right away, or you can wait it until it's cooled down first. But for me, I just want to finish it off. So for this one, we can put it aside, and then if you want, you can just add some more water. Then you can strain it one more time. Okay, now we have concentrated tamarind water. So I'm going to leave it here to cool down. Once it completely cool down, only we're going to put it in the jar. Alright, this is the tamarind water that is already cooled down. So we're going to keep it in the glass jar. The glass jar must be completely dry before you keep the tamarind water in it. So we're going to just take every utensil that you use to keep all this has to be dry, yeah? Alright, that's how simple technique to prepare the tamarind water for our daily use in the kitchen. It's very simple and easy. So next time when you want to use to make curry or anything, you just take the tamarind water and use it directly. Just one thing, right? Whenever you want to take the tamarind water, make sure that the spoon or your hand, everything must be completely dry. Don't get it contaminated with water, or else the tamarind water can become moldy. Alright, that's all for the tips of the tamarind water. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please share with your friends and remember to subscribe for more of my variety home cooking tips like this. Thank you and bye bye. This can be kept in the fridge or can be kept outside the fridge. It's okay either way.